In this tutorial, I will show you how you can start object-oriented programming in PHP. When you work with any complex application, then it is better to use object-oriented programming than procedural programming. And this tutorial shows the basics of creating class and objects. First of all, I'm going to our topics, class. Class is a user-defined content that contains some variables and functions. And object is used to access the properties which are the variables and the methods of the class. First of all, if I explain the syntax of the class, that is look like this. First, you have to use the class keyword. Then you have to define the class name, and if you want to define a multiple word class name, then you must use underscore but never use a space and a number at the starting of the class name, like which rules are followed to declare variable. Those are also applicable for defining the class name, and the variable names or methods will be defined here. An object is the variable that is used to access the properties and methods of the class. An object declaration in PHP is like this. You have to define a variable name by following the rules. And next, you have to add the keyword new before the class name to create the object. And then you can you have to write the class name with first bracket. And if you are using any constructor inside the class that I will explain in my another tutorial, then the constructor arguments value will be defined here. So in the example one, I will show you how you can declare a simple class and read the class properties. So you can create the PHP file by using any editor you want by using this code. So I am using here Visual Studio Code. So I will paste this code here. Okay. Now I will save this file in stdocs folders under PHP folder. This is stdocs PHP folder. And I will create another folder name class and keep the file here c1.php. Okay, this is the class name product. It is better to define the class name with first letter capital. Okay, here are two property are defined in this class. These are dollar name and dollar price, which are initialized inside the class. And this part is just the class declaration that has two properties, dollar name and price, and no method is declared here. Now, how to access these properties? To do this, you have to declare the object of this class. So here object name is obg underscore pro and equal to new product. Here using the first bracket is not mandatory. If you have no any constructor inside the class with arguments, then you can just create the object like this dollar object pro new product. And after declaring the object, these two properties are accessible by using this obg pro variable. So it works like an array. So if you print out the object, then you will get this value. I will show you after running this script. And next, if you want to print each property separately, then you can print this way: variable name hyphen greater than symbol, and then you can write the property name. So in these two lines, each property will be printed separately, and here both values will be printed like an array. So So now I will run this script. This is c1.php. Here you can see this is the output of the printer, and this is the output of the next two lines. Now I will go for the next example. Example 2, declare a class with properties and methods. Now I will get another script file. First of all, save the script c2.php. Okay, the class name is same here, product. There are three properties in this class. These are name, type, and price. And the method is declared here with the name details that will print the properties of this class. And this is the full parts of this class. This is the property name and this is the method. And after closing the class, here an object of this class is declared name object. And after declaring the object, you can separately print these values or like an array, like the previous example. Here, detail method is called using the object variable that will print the three property values. Those are given here. And if you print the properties inside the class method, then these keywords will be used to print the properties of the class. But in the previous example, I have printed the properties using the object variable, and in that case you have to define the object name and then the property. But if you are printing the properties inside the class, then you have to use the $this variable to recognize the property names of the class. So save the file and run the script from any browser. This is C2, and you can see the property values are shown here. Now I will go for the next example. Example 3, declare a class with properties and method with an argument. That means the method will contain one or more arguments. Now I will get another script. With the name c3.v3. Here the class name is same product, and the property values are also same here. But the method declared here is total price that contains an argument $qty. And when the property will be called by using any object, then it will calculate the total price of the product based on the quantity value. So after saving the file, and here is the object which is declared like before, and object variable name is object, and the variable quantity is declared here, which is 10. And the next total price method is called using the object variable with the quantity value 10. That means this 10 value will be passed in the variable $qty. Then it will calculate the total price based on this price value, which is 1200. So 10 will be multiplied by the 1200 and it will be returned to the caller. That means it will return here total price. And next, all the property names and the return value of the method are printed here by using this equal statement. So now I will run this script. c3.php. Here you can see name, type, here unit character is not properly right. If I again run it, see unit price, quantity 10, and the total price is 12,000. Okay, now I will go for the last example of this script. Example 4, initialize the class properties outside the class. In the previous three examples, all property values are initialized inside the class. But in this example, I will show you how you can initialize the properties outside the class. Okay, now I will create another script. With the name c4.php. Okay, the class name is same here, but the three properties are not three properties are defined, but no value is initialized for these three properties: dollar name, type, and price. And here the object variable is declared, and the values of these three properties of the class are initialized here like this: dollar object name, dollar object type, dollar object price. And the property values are also printed outside the class here. So now I will run this script. Now you can see the value is printed here. If I modified something here and refresh it from the browser, then you can see the value also changed. So in this way, you can initialize the property values of the class outside the class. And when you initialize inside the class, then you must use dollar this. And when you initialize the values outside the class, then you have to define the object variable with the property name. This is all about this tutorial, and I think the basic of class and object in PHP is clear now. Thank you for watching.